Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, we're going to be talking about one of the craziest things I've ever seen in-game, and how it sort of sparked a deeper conversation into something I want Rockstar to ultimately do. So let's begin there first. One of the best single-player updates or story mode expansions for any video game, for that matter, but in particular for Red Dead Redemption, was Undead Nightmare. And Undead Nightmare is the quintessential Rockstar DLC, at least for story modes like we've seen in Grand Theft Auto 4 and other titles, where they focus on adding new missions and new characters, new weapons and new vehicles, everything you would want from a big DLC. And it's something that a lot of people have not only speculated, but also really wanted Rockstar to do in Red Dead Redemption 2, another updated version of Undead Nightmare. And we've even seen a ton of hints and clues that Undead Nightmare references are spread all over Red Dead Redemption 2. Like, for example, the fence in Saint Denis, he actually has the green mask that can be found from Undead Nightmare, the one that John actually takes. So that's just one example right there. There's also the mysterious writing that can be found in Blackwater that Arthur or John can actually write in their journal, which translates to "Blessed are the peacemakers, I woo tail." I'm probably pronouncing that so incorrectly wrong, but that was one of the beans in Undead Nightmare. Again, just another reference right there. And then there's some pretty spooky glitches that occur at places like Bear Claw and the Sisica Penitentiary, where if you go into the certain parts of the map, it will literally look as if you are a zombie, or like all the color has been flushed from your skin, like you're undead. So all of those references and more have gotten a lot of people to thinking, well, it would be great if Rockstar did something like this in Red Dead Redemption 2. Well, I saw a post the other day on the Red Dead Mystery subreddit, and it was just a post titled "Undead Nightmare?" question mark. And it's a quick 10-second video, which I'll show you guys right now, and I'll play it a couple times so that we can actually take a look at it. It looks like it's John Marston somewhere in tall trees, and he's zooming in on two characters that literally look like either zombies or they are undead. Now, what's interesting is one of the characters looks like they have arrows sticking out of them, which again would symbolize again that they are likely undead as well. So even though this looks incredibly cool, let's talk about what this logically could be. So when I first saw this, I immediately jumped to zombies. I was like, okay, that's so cool. Maybe there are zombies we don't know about in Red Dead Redemption 2. But the more I saw it, the more how awkward they were just standing there. To me, it looks as if this is a burnt corpse animated as if it was still alive, probably due to a glitch. So I don't know how something like this happens in Red Dead Redemption 2 where someone gets killed or burned and then they ultimately come back to life. All I know is these guys were looking incredibly spooky. Now the reason that these guys might look spookier than just a normal burnt corpse is these guys look like they are the victims of the Skinner brothers. And if you've seen any of my previous videos where we talk about the dangers of traveling to an area like Tall Trees, where the Skinner brothers reside, they do some horrific stuff to their victims, like scalping them. And that's just one example right there. So that might be the reason why it's the perfect storm to see this zombie-esque character appear. But, and I want to play devil's advocate here, this would certainly not be the first time in which we've seen something mysterious like this. I've stumbled across this footage that actually shows like a living mummy. So take a look at this footage right here. It's John in Armadillo, and you can see there that it looks like literally a mummy is just sort of hopping away. How strange is that? Now, one could assume that this is a glitch as well, and that it's just a dead body that was supposed to be maybe thrown into one of the pits, sort of reincarnated itself. But this is just incredibly strange, as you can see here. Now, what's interesting is this individual tries to like grapple with the mummy, and you can actually beat or dismiss them. And after that happens, they ultimately try and run away, which is really funny. So once again, I'm not sure what ultimately causes this, but this is just so strange how there seems to be this animated mummy walking around the town of Armadillo. And speaking of Armadillo, I feel like everything that Rockstar did with the story mode aspect of the game really sets up well for Armadillo to be like the perfect spot for like an Undead Nightmare DLC to take place. Because if you think about it, it's in the desert, you've got the cholera plague that's going on, which is something that they prefaced throughout the entire story. So that right there would almost be a perfect spot in order to start like an Undead Nightmare. Another spot that would be really good is the town of Pleasance. You know, it's got that barn that says, like, plague, stay out. In fact, a lot of people assumed from the beginning that Pleasance would ultimately be the place that, you know, an update like Undead Nightmare takes place in, just because it is so mysterious and run down and a plague sort of mysteriously took it over. Now, I'm trying to think, if Rockstar did an Undead Nightmare DLC, when would it take place? You would think that they wouldn't want to make it too similar to the Undead Nightmare expansion that they did in Red Dead Redemption. So I'm trying to think, which character would it take place with? John Marston or Arthur Morgan? I think that answer is pretty obvious. It would be Arthur Morgan. But when would something like that take place? It doesn't really make sense to take place, obviously, after Chapter 6, or maybe it does. How crazy would that be if somehow they made Arthur Morgan one of the undeads who, like, came up out of the ground, relived himself? That would be insane, but probably more realistically, it would take place before the story. And I feel like Rockstar could almost kill two birds with one stone here. They give us more background on the gang's life before the start of the game, which is something I have been requesting for a long time now, like what happened in Blackwater and even beyond. But also, number two, it would be the perfect place for an Undead Nightmare DLC like that to take place, because Rockstar could introduce new characters that were never mentioned in the story mode and could also take us to new places that maybe the gang has never been. So I think that would be incredible, and if I was designing an update based off around this theme, that's where I would put something like this. Now, I talked about this the other day, but in a recent interview that Rockstar did with Game Informer, where they discussed their latest Red Dead Online update and their plans for the future, it did seem as if their focus was on multiplayer and less on single player. So I've been starting to think, okay, maybe Rockstar could do a multiplayer version of Undead Nightmare. Now, I'm not too sure how that would work, but we saw this in Grand Theft Auto Online, where some of the different aspects of GTA 5 story mode and single player DLCs eventually became content for Grand Theft Auto Online. And a lot of people seemed to enjoy that. So maybe the same thing will happen here in Red Dead Online, where content from Red Dead Redemption 2's story mode updates, if they were ever going to be called that, would eventually make their way into multiplayer. It's just something to think about, so don't be surprised if even further down the line, especially now that Red Dead Online is out of beta, that we see some really ambitious content that might have been originally meant for single player. But of course, that right there is just one example of many very freaky, creepy, and spooky things in Red Dead Redemption 2 that certainly resemble some form of an Undead Nightmare expansion. I'm sure we are going to find plenty more going forward in the future, and I'm sure there's going to be plenty other references that might pop up as well. I am just very much hoping that Rockstar don't completely abandon a single-player story mode update for Red Dead Redemption 2. But unfortunately, it's kind of looking like it's heading in that direction with what we saw with GTA 5, what we're seeing with Grand Theft Auto Online, what we're seeing now with Red Dead Online. It looks like Rockstar's focus is definitely on multiplayer and way less on single-player, which is unfortunate because, like myself and many others, there's a ton of people that absolutely love the single-player experience and would want to see Rockstar dive back into that. But as always, I would love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Let me know what you think about our discoveries today. Do you think they mean anything, or do you think they're just simple glitches that happen to sort of resemble a Undead Nightmare-ish scenario? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new, or you like daily Red Dead Redemption 2 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.